She is heaven.
Yeah, I want to see this. Please.
There's just something about her eyes that screams heaven to me. She looks like the girl.
Bring this one.
So you're ready to see more talent?
Does a bear shit in the woods?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Are we all set?
Yes, we're all set. Everyone's headshots and resumes are in. Great.
Send in the next talent.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hi, Stacy.
I'm you. You're gonna be auditioning for Mister. He's our casting director, and I'll be your reader today.
It's a pleasure to meet you both, and an honor to be here.
Yeah. So, will you be standing or seated for your audition?
Standing.
Okay. Yeah, I'd prefer you sit, please. Thank you.
Okay, no problem.
Before you sit, can you give us a slate?
Sure. Hi, my name is Stacy. I'm 5'7". Representation is High Talent Agency, and today I'm reading for the role of Heather.
Okay. All right, so bottom of the page, we'll start there.
Okay.
Oh, you know, before we begin, could you separate your legs a bit for me, please? Thank you.
Sure.
Okay, bottom of the page, okay?
You know, on second thought, let's try this. Lean back a little bit, just be comfortable, and open your legs wider. Okay. So, for your insight, Heather comes across as the girl next door, right? But she's not. And admittedly, we are interested in seeing your range as an actor, you know. We love to see how far our actors can go. I mean, if you think about it, versatility is how you're going to get ahead in this business. Think of all of the greats. Just food for thought. Okay. I'll shoot it to you straight, because I think you can handle it. You got the looks, no doubt. And you have the character. Question is, do you have the heart? Are you willing to do what it takes? Just go with it. Just go the extra mile. Hugh, please. Please, Hugh.
Listen, sweetie, you only get one chance to prove yourself. There are 10 other girls out there right now who can't wait to get into this room. But right now, this room belongs to you. This is your room. This is your moment. So you need to own it.
Okay.
Great. Let's get started, shall we? No one knows me like the piano
in my mother's home. So what do you want to watch? Power Rangers or SpongeBob?
I don't care. You're the babysitter.
Look. Okay. I'm sorry if I hurt your feelings earlier. But you're just a kid, and besides, I have a boyfriend.
See, that's the problem. A girl like you deserves a man.
You're too young to be wanting to be someone's man.
Great. That was excellent. We're going to do it again. This time, while you're reading, I want you to make it a little bit more sultry. Yeah, like, as you're reading, think about what it would feel like to make love to Devin.
But Devin's only 15 years old and I'm his babysitter. It doesn't make any sense.
What doesn't make sense?
I just don't understand. What's motivating you?
I am motivating her, that's who. Okay? Hugh, can I have the room, please? Hugh, can I have the room, please? The question you need to ask yourself is, do you want this? No, do you really want this? Do you? Good. Then just do what I'm asking you to do. Okay? From the top.
I knew we couldn't cope.
Is everyone all set?
We're all set. Stacy Jones. The cast member is ready to see you. Good luck.
Long day?
Long week.
I heard that.
I think that's yours.
Oh, I'm not in a rush.
Please, you were here first. Oh, in here, I got it. Excuse me. Oh, just charge. For all of it.
Thank you.
Surrender to the good law and wipe your safety. Take me to your river.
Hey, sorry to interrupt. You mind if I sit down?
Oh, no, not at all. I hope you didn't get the wrong impression.
No, I understand.
That's a relief, because you know these days you can't talk to a guy without him getting the wrong impression.
So, you are still acting?
No. God, no. That part of my life is closed. How did you know I was an actress?
Lucky guess.
No. Nobody's that lucky. Do I know you? Like, who are you?
Okay. All right. Be right. We do know each other. We've met before.
When? Where?
A year ago. You auditioned for casting director. The role was for a secret agent for a major streaming network. You got a call back.
Is it normal for callbacks to take place late at night like this?
I assure you, this is standard. The entertainment industry has its own ways of doing things. Most are unconventional but effective.
just do what you gotta do to get what you want.
You took me to see Mister.
That was me. Wait, please, listen, I just—
Don't touch me!
Okay, listen. I'm not here to cause a scene. I want to talk about what happened.
How do you know what happened? You was there 1 minute and you was gone the next.
Oh, good evening, my dear. Mwah. Mwah. Thank you. Thank you for coming on such short notice. Take a seat. Get comfortable. Talk with me. So, as you can imagine, this business never sleeps. Decisions, yes. Decisions are made around the clock. And I have to tell you, this is a big one. I hope you're ready.
Of course. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
It's my pleasure. I mean, you were wonderful.
Really?
Oh, the director went on and on about how much he wants you to play this role. I do have to be forthright and tell you that there are a number of other actresses that are in consideration for this role as well.
Oh.
It's okay. Given my position and influence, I am confident that I can sway his opinion in your direction. Would you like a cocktail? Come on, one drink won't hurt.
Sure.
Great.
You know what you did to me? And now you want to help me.
I was blacklisted because I rejected it.
Everybody in the industry knows that it's happening, but everybody's too scared to say anything.
He invited me up to his hotel suite to discuss my film and possible Oscar campaign. And once we were alone, he pressed up against me and tried to pull my sweater off. It was by the grace of God that I managed to escape. And when I called the female executive who had arranged the meeting, she advised me to say nothing.
I agreed to meet with the major Hollywood exec to look at a new script. I was told by his assistant to come up to his hotel room instead of our initial agreement to meet over dinner. I was let inside and he met me wearing only a bathrobe. He grabbed me multiple times. I refused him, and he told me I was making a big mistake. I'm 100% sure I lost the role because of him.
Everyone says to speak up about it. Well, I did, publicly. And do you know he had the nerve to say he didn't remember asking me to turn around? But if he did, he wasn't being serious. and was only doing what the casting agent had told him to do. And then he turned around and made himself out to be the victim. The nerve.
He just pulled his penis out and started masturbating in front of me. I was instantly sick to my stomach.
I was surrounded by pedophiles ever since I was 14 years old. I didn't even know it until I was old enough to realize what they were and what they wanted. You ain't got nobody.
Would you like to share your experience this week?
I don't think I can at this time.
It's okay. Just as time heals our wounds, it also lets us know when we are ready to let others help us mend those wounds. There is no need to rush the healing process. Let's give time. It's due diligence.
3:30 has arrived, sir.
Thank you, you. Cocktail. You know, it's been nice having you as my assistant over this journey. Wouldn't you agree? I just want you to know, you, there's a whole world out here for you. A world you would not believe. A world where people like me have power. That's the world you want to be a part of. If you're serious about moving ahead in this business. Are you serious, you? Do you want to move ahead? Or do you want to get left behind? Well, while you chew on that, fetch me my next star.
Okay. You're good. You're okay. This is the way they do things, and there's nothing to worry about. You're gonna book this. You're gonna rock this, right? Yeah.
Hi.
Hey, is it normal to have callbacks late at night like this?
Yes. Of course. This is standard. It's the entertainment industry. We do stuff that's crazy, but it's one in a lifetime opportunity. So just do what you gotta do, okay? To get what you want.
Yes, may I help you?
Sorry for showing up unannounced, but I
Yes?
My name's Hugh. I'm here to speak with your son.
What do you need to speak with my son about?
It's an important matter I think he should be made aware of.
What type of matter? Do you know my son?
Yes, we've met before on a project. It was a brief encounter, but some things happened that I think he and you should be made aware of. You mind if I come in?
It's okay, Mom.
Where are my manners? Of course. Please. My son's popularity is growing since he started his YouTube channel. People stop by all the time to congratulate him or to ask for a photo. Still, gotta be cautious.
You know, you do look familiar, but I can't place your face. Are you sure we've met before?
Well, not formally. Like I said, it was a brief encounter. But look, you may not remember me, but...
Did my agent send you?
No. Actually, I'm here on my own accord.
Oh, okay. So what's this all about?
Can I offer you something to eat? To drink?
No, thank you, I'm fine.
Perhaps a glass of lemonade.
A glass of lemonade would be great, thank you.
So, Mr.
Langston. Hugh Langston.
Well, that's cute. All right, Mr. Langston, how about we cut to the chase?
Absolutely. Oh, man, this is amazing. Pretty impressive.
A lot of hard work with a dash of luck. That's the key. Who you know doesn't hurt either.
Who you know? That's actually why I'm here to speak.
Okay. Well, Mom likes to make fresh lemonade, so you got time.
You may want to sit down for this.
I'm fine where I am, thank you.
Right. 3 years ago, you sent in a tape audition. You got a call back, and for that call back, you met with my former boss. He was the casting director. I was his assistant.
Dude. 3 years ago, I was auditioning my ass off, trying to get a big break. You'll have to be more specific.
Right. Well, this was the audition that gave you your big break. You know? The one that took you from here to here. Do you remember that moment? Do you remember? I remember. I remember because I was the one that contacted you to set up that audition. Working a double, she couldn't take you. You were dropped off at the hotel where I greeted you in the lobby, guided you to the suite. So young.
Eve. This is what he likes. I instructed you to wait by the door as I went in, closing it behind me. And there he sat, like so many times before, readying his specialty cocktails. I let him know you were waiting. As always, he offers me a drink.
Cocktail.
As always, I decline. And then I left. As I walked past you, I said to you,
this is your moment. Own it. I remember.
On my way home, all I could think about was how lucky I was to have to not put myself in that kind of position to get ahead in this industry. Of course, I've made sacrifices, but I never thought it cost me as much as it costs. So I thought, one night, he invited me out for drinks with the rest of the team. I accepted the invite. He has so much reach in his industry. Everyone facilitates him. We all went out for drinks. And the night was going good. Drinks kept coming. Good times. All around. And he was charming. Flirting with everybody. Touching on everybody. I remember him groping me in the hallway as I was coming out of the bathroom. You see, I've been made aware of his touches and feels, his accidental grabs, often touching, then immediately apologizing as though it was an honest mistake. But when he groped me at that party, I was enraged. Pushed him away. He laughed it off like it was a joke, saying he was just trying to make sure I was packing enough down below. Saying he had a hot young actress down for a threesome. He needed proper backup. He laughed. Everyone else laughed too, normalizing his behavior. We get back to his place. Sure enough, there's a high young actress. Man, she was so out of it. I can't lie. At this point, I was envious of the power and the access he had, and how others in his circle can do whatever they wanted, whenever they wanted, and get away with it without consequence. I wanted a piece. I wanted to know what that felt like. He pours up some drinks. After a few sips, all I can remember is feeling heavy and nothing.
Why did you come here?
I came here to do what I should have done a long time ago.
What? Dredge up people's painful past so you can clear your conscience?
No. I came because I too am a victim. I too am a survivor. We are fighting the same fight. We share the same pain. We share the same enemy.
If you think that my son is gonna jeopardize everything we work for just so you can send one pervert to prison? You're crazy. We have made painful sacrifices to get here. You can't win this fight.
Yes. Yes. We can win, even if we have to take them down one by one.
They're like weeds in this industry. For every one you get rid of, two more pop up. And what's worse, word travels fast around here. If what my son had to endure, if people find out what was done to him, he will never work in this industry again.
Please. There are others. I've met with them. I've met with others, just as I've met with you today. When they join, we will not be alone.
No.
We won't have to do it alone.
My son will not martyr himself for somebody else's movement.
Just think of the others out there. Being victimized in exchange for much less.
Were you thinking of me? When I was being victimized? Were you there for me? You knew what was going on and you did nothing. So fuck you and your self-righteous movement.
Thank you for your concern, but I think you better be going. And you can let yourself out. Get out.
And I hope you know what you're doing. I hope you know what you're getting yourself into.
I was not aware that so many women endured so much pain at the hands of sexually deviant, powerful men because we share the same pain. I found the courage to take my matter up the chain of command without the fear of retribution.
There is power in our numbers. And I know, together, we will form the icebergs that the big ships fear in the middle of the night. Thank you. Thank you for sharing. And we do have time for one more. Well, all right. I guess this will conclude our time.
Hi. My name is Hugh. I too am a survivor.
Seeing shows in evening clothes with you. From nervous times and getting drunk. To staying up and waking up with you. And I was sleeping at the edge. Holding something we don't need. All this delusion in our heads is gonna bring us to our knees. So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. Everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. Why don't you? Across the floor to teeth and claws and slamming doors at you. If this is all we're living for, why are we doing it, doing it, doing it anymore? I used to recognize myself. It's funny our affections change. Becoming something else, I think it's time to walk away. So come on, let it go.